Welcome to new discussion in Remote Sensing Essentials course. And today we are going to discuss frequency domain Fourier transformation. Earlier we have also discussed spatial domain filtering or spatial filtering. So instead of in a spatial domain, there is another way of doing filtering by first transforming into Fourier domain and then doing whatever the filtering we want to do it, and then again backward transformation to a spatial domain. So by doing this thing, we can also achieve very good results. And in this discussion, I will be also showing some examples from it. As you recall that when we have been discussing the spatial filtering. At that time, a similar kind of curve came, that the bottom one which you are seeing here is a combined curve, but by using filtering techniques, single dimensional or linear filtering techniques, it is possible to, you know, take out all these frequencies or waves separately. And this is what it is shown here, that this is the input or the original wave. And then this one, and that one becomes your output after filtering. So this Jean-Baptiste Fourier way back in 1768 introduced this one, that by identifying that any periodic function which we are seeing in form of waves can be expressed as a weighted sum, which is the bottom one is representing, of sines and cosines or Fourier series. So having this concept in the background, it is possible to filter out many things from original wave. And this is what the bottom image is, the sum of the four functions which are shown above. And this Fourier's idea, which was of course propagated in 1768, later on in 1807, that periodic functions could be represented as a weighted sum of sines and cosines was met with skepticism. Means people did not believe initially, were not accepting, but later on it was accepted. This figure we have discussed while discussing the spatial filtering techniques or spatial domain filtering techniques, where the top one again is sum of the three waves which are shown in the bottom. So the bottom one is the cumulative effect, and the top one is the cumulative effect of the three waves which are shown in the bottom image. Other functions which can be expressed as integral of sines and cosines multiply by weighing functions or Fourier transform, and the functions can also be recovered by the inverse operations with no loss of information. That means if I put an image in the which is originally in a spatial domain and transform it Fourier transform, and then whatever the modifications or filtering or anything which I want to perform, I can do it in Fourier transformation, and again I can come back in the spatial domain. And of course there will not be any loss to the information of or the image, but only thing, the filtering can be performed very efficiently. And of course the main application of this Fourier transformation or frequency domain filtering technique is in to enhance our images, like spatial filtering techniques. And a image or a natural scene can be regarded as reconstructed from a spectrum of sine waves with different directions and wavelengths and amplitudes. After all, an image is made from these things, and such a reconstruction is known as Fourier thinsesis. So an image can be converted into this, and then again backward thing can be done, that disassembly of an image into a family of sine waves in a Fourier analysis. So spots, lines, bars that form the targets of the test of acuity and form images too are themselves made of the sine waves. So small dots and closely spaced lines are dominated by high amplitude at high frequency, and this is why they are difficult to recognize in the images or later on in the waves. So as size increases, high frequency components become lower in amplitude, and those in the frequency range to which the eye is attenuated increase, and this way and the perception and distinctions becomes easier. And beyond this, however, very low frequency components increase in amplitude, effectively degrading perception and distinction. So basically, if you recall the original discussion which we started on image enhancement particularly, the main purpose here, ultimate purpose, is to improve the image in such a way that our interpretation or perception or distinction between different objects becomes much easier. So this is of course a Fourier transformation is a mathematical technique which is separating an image into various frequency components is Fourier, and that whole thing is called Fourier analysis. And the basic principles, as we have already discussed, from a cumulative image, these components can be separated, and whichever we want to get rid of may be noise, and then reconstruct the original thing. So Fourier transform of an image, when we do it, so this wave scenario is a single dimensional, whereas our images are in a spatial domain and they are two dimensional. So Fourier transformation of image, which is a result of a separation, expresses the spatial attributes on image in terms of their frequency, amplitude and their orientation, basically about the construction of an image using pixels. And it is a transform that enable, the Fourier transform basically enable certain groups of frequencies and directions to be emphasized or suppressed by algorithm known as filters. So once a spatial domain image is transformed into frequency domain image, then it is possible using by some algorithms or some techniques, we can remove certain things, we can emphasize certain things like we have been doing in a spatial filtering, and then those things can be suppressed or emphasized, and later on we can come back again in a spatial domain. So those that emphasize high frequencies and suppress low frequencies are high pass filters. Similarly, in a spatial domain also, when we would like to highlight the local variations present in the image and we want to suppress the regional variations, then we use the high pass filter. And in reverse also, when we want to highlight the regional features and we want to suppress local features, then we say low pass filter. So similar thing here, with that which emphasizes high frequency and suppresses low frequencies are high pass filters, and inverse approach is the low pass filter. Moreover, selected ranges of spatial frequencies can be removed completely, maybe noise, or retained in the resulting image using band stop band pass filter. So similar kind of filters are also there in frequency domain too, and this process is analogous to the electronic filtering in amplifiers in electronic devices to reduce certain noises like hiss and rubble, enhance the bass or treble, and so on a sound recording. So when we turn these knobs, this is what, because the information is already, data is already in the frequency domain. But in case of images, original images are satellite images which we are talking, which we want to enhance, are in spatial domain. So first that step, that from a spatial domain to frequency domain has to be performed. And filtering can be implemented through the Fourier transform when it is set to operate the frequency domain or in spatial domain of image itself by process, that is in a spatial domain the process we say is convolution filtering or a spatial filtering. And a frequency domain filtering is more powerful, but it is also more expensive of computer time. It takes a lot of time because two times the transformation has to happen, because first from a spatial domain to frequency domain, then you do the filtering and then come back again reverse transformation, backward transformation from frequency domain to spatial domain, and therefore it consumes lot of computer resources. Nonetheless, it is sometimes on certain images we find that it is better than spatial domain filtering. And of course the mathematical part is complex as compared to spatial domain, and the results of transformation is not easily visualized in terms of image itself unless it is transformed back from frequency domain to spatial domain. And most image processing systems they support convolution filtering easily, but if you want to do this spatial frequency filtering or frequency based filtering, that Fourier transformation that may also be supported, but that is not a common thing because it requires a lot of coding and due to the complex mathematics. So instead of using a spatial domain, that is the x and y coordinate space of an image, row number, column number, an alternative coordinate space can also be used for image analysis, that is in frequency domain. And this approach, image is separated into various spatial frequency components through application of a mathematical operation known as Fourier transformation. And conceptually, this amounts to fitting a continuous function through a discrete pixel values if they were plotted along each row and column in the image. So when we find these peaks and valleys along any given row or column, can be described mathematically by a combination of sine and cosine waves with various amplitudes, frequencies and phases, because we will be getting a cumulative effect, and that we can later on filter it. So frequency domain, basically when we say frequency domain, it refers to the plane of two dimensional discrete Fourier transform of an image. And basically the purpose of Fourier transform is to represent a signal as a linear combination of sinusoidal signals of various frequencies. There are different types of functions or Fourier transforms and the frequency domain. One we consider as one dimensional, and the mathematics is given here, and the first step is of course Fourier transforms for continuous case, and then inverse of course has to be done. So first forward and then backward transformation, and two dimensional Fourier transform and it is inverse. So that mathematics part is here, that Fourier transforms for continuous case again, but it is in case of two dimensional. Further, the one dimensional Fourier transform and its inverse is in discrete case rather than in continuous case is also possible. And once an image is separated, that is from a spatial domain into components to the frequency, it is possible to display these values in a two-dimensional scatter plot known as Fourier spectrum. as you can also recall in the two-dimensional histogram or scattered plot, almost similar thing here, that you see different pixel values. And what we see in these scatter plots, that the lower frequencies in the scene or an image are plotted at the center of the spectrum, and when you go away from the center progressively, higher frequencies are plotted outward, and that way you get a Fourier spectrum. And this the features basically trending horizontally in a original image results in a vertical components is a sort of reverse plotting in a Fourier spectrum, and features which are aligned vertically in original image result in horizontal components in the Fourier spectrum. And if the Fourier spectrum of image is known, that has to be first created in the frequency domain filtering or Fourier filtering, it is possible to regenerate the original image through backward transformation application of this inverse Fourier transform. And this operation is simply the mathematical reversal of Fourier transform. And therefore, the Fourier spectrum of an image can be used to assist in number of image processing software. The main application of Fourier transformation is basically for filtering, and though as a spatial filtering can be accomplished by applying a filter directly on Fourier spectrum and then performing the inverse transform. Now we will take some example here. On the left image, on the left side, that is figure A, what you are seeing an image which is the original scene, and when we create a Fourier spectrum, this is what we see. So the features which are in north-south directions are implemented here, are represented here in the near horizontal direction, and features which are near horizontal in original image are represented in vertical direction. And then as recall that and low frequency features will be coming at the in the center of this Fourier spectrum, and high frequency features will get plotted outside or away from the center. Now if I want to perform a filtering, so the B1 is the original Fourier spectrum, and here the Fourier spectrum in this example the same image is basically, and here the inner part has been dropped or filtered out, and what we see that B represents here the image and D represents the output, and therefore these directional things which were either oriented roughly east west or north south were highlighted in the image, and rest of the features have been suppressed. So in a spatial filtering, a high frequency blocking filter, and the B is of course inverse transform of A in this one, and A is the low frequency blocking, so a low pass filter has been performed, and then of course inverse transformation. So original image, A is the original image here, B is the spatial filtered image, and A is basically A or this B are the almost same, and then C you are having low pass frequency filtering, and D is final output. So likewise you can do filtering, but it takes a lot of time and care has to be taken while performing the filtering. So frequency filtering, there are these steps, very quickly we will go, as also shown to you the figures, that first original image is transformed into its frequency representation using Fourier transform and creating a Fourier spectrum. by employing image processing, selecting an appropriate filter. In the example, we selected this low pass thing and filter transform function and multiplying its elements of the Fourier spectrum. And of course, then finally, once the filtering has been done, then inverse transform function or a Fourier transform is performed to return to the spatial domain for display purpose. If you recall that there will not be any loss of information. Suppose somebody transforms from spatial domain to frequency domain and no changes, no filtering is done, and later on if we do the backward transformation, there should not be any loss to the image quality. And this is what is done, except that in the middle stage, when it is we are having a Fourier spectrum, at that time filtering, either low pass or high pass filtering, can be applied, and then inverse transformation, and we can have better results. Few more examples are here, and this is short wave infrared image of JER-5 satellite. And what you are seeing in image A, there is lot of noise is there, and how to remove that noise is a very quick way or very best possible way. Rather than employing a spatial filtering, we can apply this frequency domain filtering and can create a Fourier spectrum like B, which we are seeing. As you can see that because there are a lot of stripes are there, and therefore vertical line in the Fourier spectrum, you are seeing roughly north-south lines or north-south plotting, and also some east-west. And if we remove those parts and consider that this is our valid data, rest is this is, as mentioned here, a horizontal noise. It is also in the top here also, that is shown here. So this is horizontal noise, and diagonal noise also might be there. So the central part we consider as a valid data during the filtering, and then when this is inverse transformation is done from frequency domain to spatial domain, we get this result D on the extreme right image. And if you compare image A versus D, then you can see the significant changes in the quality of an image. The noise which was there because of these drop lines or maybe stripes problem and maybe some calibration issues with the sensor, all have disappeared through this frequency domain filtering. So that's the very big advantage, and this kind of error which we are seeing in image A cannot be removed through spatial filtering. This I am telling from my own image processing experience, but it is rather easy and that one can get rid of such errors through Fourier transformation and frequency domain filtering. So this kind of advantage which we are seeing through this image is possible. So one can also say here that these are in some way the spatial filtering and this frequency domain filtering, they are complementary to each other. When one we doesn't get the desired results, especially removing noise and other such features, which may be because of poor calibration in the sensor arrays, then the rescue or the resort is for us is to go in the frequency domain, do the filtering and do the backward transformation from frequency spatial and get a result like the rightmost image here. One more example shown here, that was Landsat 2 MSS. At that time, when these satellites in 1975-76, these sensors were not that reliable as today's sensors, because electronics has improved significantly in those 45 years. So these, because of poor calibrations or because of some cross-track scanners and other problems, there are a lot of drop lines which you are seeing in the left image, the original image. And when it is subjected to frequency domain filtering, you can see that all that noise or those drop lines or stripes effects which are seen here have completely been removed, and you get a very high quality image from the same data set. So that's the advantage of recall the that in one dimensional, when you are getting noises through your amplifier, what do? You filter certain noises and you get a clear voice. Similarly here, in a spatial domain, when there are noises like this on left image, we can apply this frequency domain filtering and can get rid of those noises. There cannot be for each image, one has to be little innovative, one has to find out where noise has got plotted, and then you can get rid of that one. So this one has to take care. So methods which are which we involve on identifying the frequency and amplitude of stripping and all other pervasive systematic defects which we have seen in few of these examples are superimposed on the real variation and by analyzing a Fourier transform of an image. So this which part has to be removed, and that has to be carefully chosen, that filtered out, what should be the filtered out from the image. And this periodic noise like a striping can then be identified as a signal and suppressed by filtering in the frequency domain. And once it is done, then inverse transformation from frequency domain to spatial domain and restores the original image without having striping effects or noise effects. So in the frequency domain, the noise is isolated as distinct signal and almost wholly removed, fully removed by specially designed filters and that operates in the frequency domain. And one more example here, too many these lines or striping example is there on the top left image. And therefore, in Fourier spectrum, you are seeing a vertical line. These lines are plotted in Fourier spectrum opposite to what you see in the images. This one has to remember. And now we know that this vertical in the Fourier spectrum, these vertical component has to be removed through filtering. And this is what is done in C. In figure C, this is what you see, that these horizontal lines in the image or vertical plots in the Fourier spectrum is removed, and when a backward transformation is done, then the entire horizontal striping effects in the image has completely disappeared. So this is an example of airborne multispectral scanner image which is containing substantial noise, as you can also realize. And this vertical wedge which you are seeing has been blocked filtering and applied to the Fourier spectrum, and this filter passes low and lower frequency components of the image but blocks the high frequency components. Remember that low frequency components would be in the center, high frequency component would be outside. And by inverse transformation, you get basically the finally the D image. So Fourier analysis is useful, as you must have realized by now, in many of image processing operations, especially in filtering or image restoration also, it is can be applied. However, also one can realize that it is not easy to implement because of complex mathematics and consequently complex computer programming, nonetheless a very popular and a very powerful image processing softwares have all implemented this, and you may find those functions available with those softwares. And if today some softwares are not supporting frequency domain transformation, filtering and backward transformation, I'm sure in few years time, in near future, they too will implement this thing, because I said that in some way it is a complement to spatial filtering. It is not a competitive filtering technique, but it is a complementary filtering technique, because the power it is having to remove these strives or noises in the image is much more useful, much more powerful than doing in the spatial domain. So this brings to the end of this discussion. Thank you very much.